sense. Is my wife trying to kill me?
Is your wife trying to kill me? I've missed this.
Yeah,
I've missed this. Ready?
I've been ready, dude. You see me
sitting
here?
You always do that. What's up, guys? Welcome back to JPMP. I'm Justin.
I'm Manny. Hello.
And we are back again. What is this, by the way? Because people are going to ask, like, what are you drinking? Besides the water.
Coke and whiskey. No, I'm sorry. Not whiskey. It's like Coke and... It's like a Kentucky... It's alcohol and Coke.
Thank you.
That's what it is.
There you go. Today, we are listening to Darondo with the song Didn't I? This song came up on my YouTube recommendations just randomly one night. Mm-hmm. And I didn't listen to it. But it had a good amount of views. I've never heard of the guy or the song, so I just thought, let's just kind of jump into it.
I feel good. I feel happy.
It's good. Feel refreshed?
I feel refreshed.
Were you looking forward to this?
I was looking forward to it. I was talking to Ashley about it. I'm just like, it's going to be cool.
Ashley?
My wife. And I was like, it's going to be cool to just, like, chill and just do this.
Yeah. It's nice for me to talk to someone else.
Yeah.
Now.
No, you've been doing really good.
I know.
Your lighting... Okay, I'm not even worried about the content. I'm looking at his lighting and, like, how everything looks. It looks really good.
Colors. Look at this one.
Fancy.
Right?
The red ring of death for many Xbox users.
Look at that. Oh, hang on. I'm coming. Oh, what?
What? You got two colors?
So, basically, the story behind the set change is more editing, faster computer. I still didn't want to get rid of the classic shelf. I think when this channel gets a little bit bigger and more popular... We're going to auction off the shelf, but not with the stuff on it.
Can I have it?
No. No, but so maybe when we upgrade, so we can auction off the shelf, and then someone can have it and be like, oh, this was the JPMP shelf, with maybe a couple things on there.
It's like an IKEA shelf.
It's not IKEA.
Target?
No, it's Wayfair.
Who's that? Not sponsored.
Man, you don't know.
Thank you guys so much for... Whoa, fried it. Thank you guys so much for watching. Seriously appreciate it. Continue to watch us here. Continue to join us on Twitter. What was that?
Sorry. Ashley?
I dropped the vacuum.
Better suck it up. Join us on Twitter. Join us in the comments below. We love having discussions with you guys. Of course, join me on my solo channel, Just JP. And let's get into it. This is Darondo with the song, Didn't I? We're both trying to get things to pull up.
Technical difficulties. Give me a second.
That was good.
That was awesome.
That was smooth.
Yeah.
That was just really easy listening, smooth, like this.
You got Childish Gambino, right?
At the beginning, yes. Just vocally, but...
Vocally, I thought it was really, really
yes,
cool.
But let's be honest. Any, for the most part, any man that sings in a falsetto...
Well, no, I think with Gambino, you have a little bit more of a vocal fry. But then with The Weeknd, you have a little bit less of... It's a little bit more smoother, so...
Yeah.
Because when I first heard Donald Glover sing like that in that falsetto kind of voice, I'm like, oh, that's... you don't expect it from him. And so when I heard this, I'm like, it was very distinct to me.
Right.
Let us know what you guys think in the comments.
Yeah. Well, before we even get into it, let us know what you guys think of the song.
Yeah.
That way our opinions aren't like affecting your opinions.
I don't know. We're sorry. It's good.
I liked it. Definitely I liked it. It was good. I liked the way he changes his voice. I did not expect that at all. The way he goes from his falsetto... And then you hear his deep voice come in. It almost sounds like a second singer.
Yeah, almost like a second singer. And then it gets that, I feel it goes back to like that Barry...
White?
White.
Yeah.
I almost said Manilow. No, like, that's the wrong... That's the wrong Barry.
Side of the line.
Yeah.
No, but I really did like it. I like the way that other instruments are brought in. And in a lot of old soul and old funk like this, you have a lot of that. So you have the violin and the strings that come in.
And a lot of old funk, really?
Yeah, yeah. Because they incorporate a lot of instruments. You have to think of the evolution from where funk and soul came from.
Okay.
It comes from jazz. Big band, where they have other instruments going on, because it's like an orchestra, but in a more jazzy and funk-driven way. Mm-hmm. So you have bands like what we did with...
Earth, Wind & Fire.
Thank you. And they have other instruments and stuff coming in, you know?
Yeah.
To back up the vocals, but then show off on their own.
Yeah, and I think that's the cool thing, because it almost had like... I feel like this was like the standards version of funk.
Yeah, yeah.
In a sense. Because it had that very... It was very subdued in a lot of ways, but what I like the most about it is the subtlety. So then...
Yes.
The violins coming in.
The flute.
The flute.
I really like the flute.
Was he just even like whistling too?
I don't know. I'd have to... I didn't hear it, but that's the problem with the first listen.
Anyway.
Sometimes I miss things.
But I think the bass work was probably my favorite.
I think my favorite part, besides the subtle instruments that were in there, is the guitar. Just the way that it kind of breaks down.
I didn't even hear the guitar.
Then he goes into his verse and he goes...
Yeah, bass...
I like the way it was working.
Bass and vocal for me.
Now, one thing I didn't like vocally is the same thing that I actually mentioned.
It's too abrupt, isn't it?
Too abrupt and it doesn't add anything really to the... Yeah, yeah. It feels like it was just kind of thrown in there, and then immediately, like, it's gone.
Yeah, and it could be, like, just the way that he sings.
Yeah, yeah. It could just be his style. But when... Okay, you're used to the falsetto voice. Okay, this is really cool. Mm-hmm. Then he goes into his regular, normal voice. Okay, cool. It sounds good.
Right.
But the thing is, it only does it for, like, a quick little portion, and then it's right back to the falsetto.
And it's not that anything... There's anything wrong with, like, throwing something in for spice. Mm-hmm. But, like, for example, when we were listening to Michael McDonald, what was the song?
I keep forgetting.
The very end had that double bass.
Right.
It was like it was a throw-in, and you can notice it was very, very subtle. Here, it was just like... I don't even want to say it was abrupt. It was more apparent.
Yeah. And it stood out.
It stood out. Mm-hmm. That doesn't ruin the song at all. I'm just saying, like, I just think it's interesting.
Yeah, yeah. And going back to really quickly to the guitar. In the guitar part, it almost sounded a little bluesy.
Yeah.
In the way that it was.
But
I like that.
You would expect that in a kind of a funky... What genre is he?
Soul.
Yeah, you would expect that.
Absolutely, because it's all incorporated together.
Yeah.
Lyrically, it's pretty straightforward. It's typical.
Mm-hmm. Do you go into lyrics in Just JP?
How many videos have you watched from me?
Like 5. You put them on every day! I'm not watching every single one. I definitely watched the Utada Hiro...
Hikaru versus the other one.
That was cool.
Yeah.
I like that one.
Which version did you like?
I like the original version.
I like the
original version. No. The original version was from the game, right?
Yes.
From Utah? Yeah.
Yes.
I like that one.
But you also know that one, right?
Yes. You know what's funny? Mm-hmm. I had listened to that originally and I didn't like it. I'm like, I don't like it because it wasn't when you...
Right.
It was,
granted.
Right. And even the second one, I'm just like, my sanctuary. I don't like that one either. Yeah. Like, nothing beats the first game. And then I listened to this one, I'm like...
Had to give it a second listen.
Yeah.
You had to hear it outside, maybe.
Yeah,
of the game.
It was good.
Yeah, yeah.
I liked it.
I liked it because it didn't sound like Skrillex was being Skrillex. It just sounded like it was reined in.
Well, it goes back to this point again. It doesn't, like, when things are not... Okay, I think I've said this in, like, a ton of other videos.
We're going to repeat ourselves.
What makes a good song is the fact that nothing is overpowering somebody else. Mm-hmm. What are some songs we give, like, a 5?
Genesis, Firth of Fifth?
Yes. That's a good example because... though it's a long song, but in that it's like you have like portions of your plate that are not overbearing the other one. I just think food.
I love everyone.
Can relate to food. Sure, everyone can relate to food, and I don't. For that one person that was just like, "There's more important things than food." Listen, dude, come on, man. Like,
I think we know that there's more important things than food.
Of course, there's more.
But food is a universal thing that
It's just an example and analysis. So you know what. You're blocked anyway, so don't worry about it. To that point where Skrillex wasn't sounding too Skrillex.
Right.
When nothing is overbearing on other instruments or overpowering like the vocals or overpowering even like a snare hit can be like too much. When everything is in balance, shout out to Thanos. When everything's in balance, everything works well together.
Yes.
So, for example, in that song, I'm sorry to like bring it back to that song.
With
that song. Go watch that video. It was a really good video.
Thank you.
Good job.
Thank you.
But what I liked about it is that Skrillex has his thing, right? Yep.
Oh yes, he does.
But it wasn't overbearing. He knew how to subdue it, which added to the song.
They both perfectly balanced.
So this
let's bring it back to Darondo.
So Darondo, I think honestly it may just be a preference thing.
Okay.
It might just be a preference thing. I didn't prefer that. I enjoyed his falsetto type of right. I like that.
Did I treat you right?
That was good.
Thank you.
You got the.
I got the.
Did I
got you.
Yeah, that was good. That was good.
I shouldn't have sang the falsetto. You liked it,
but when he went very very deep, it just
yeah.
So for that. We give it a 4.
Okay.
I would like to listen to more of him.
Okay.
Like on a record?
Right. Yeah.
I could just chill to that.
Yeah.
By the way, I've been listening to a lot of... a lot of...
Pink Floyd.
No, actually not. I've been listening to actually a lot of... Kindo was one
great band,
and I say that because their latest album is very. We gotta talk about it. We're gonna talk about it. But we were. What's the word? The album's very samba. It's very different than what I listened to. Something else I've been listening to. I can't even pronounce it. Hang on. Something else I've been listening to. Here's what you do, guys.
Here's what you do.
You go to Goodwill, right?
Very.
And
true.
You go to the 50-cent record. Area that's like tucked in a corner with like socks all over
and
it.
Dust.
And then you buy George Philip Telemann in honor of his 300th anniversary concerti quartets and trios in the French and Italian manner. I love it.
Classical?
I think it's classical. Sorry.
I was like, what?
Yeah, it's classical. I have no idea what this stuff means, but I'd like to listen to it. Preludio, Corale, and Fuga.
Fuga.
I think it's Italian.
It's the prelude.
Yeah, it's an Italian pianist.
Okay.
Cesar Franck? Franck?
Yeah, that's right.
Franck. It's been really, really good. I just wanted to throw that little tidbit out there. I say that because Kindo was something that was different, and then this is something that was a little different.
For you.
Yeah. The first half of Kindo's album was very different.
You know what's funny? I've actually gotten into the... I like the faster-paced songs now. Before I liked the slower ones, now I like the faster ones.
Because I
saw them live.
Well, it was funny. Exactly. I listened to it the other day.
Yeah. I got bored of the slow ones.
And I'm just like, oh, I like Human Convention. Like, that's...
Oh, yeah. It's really good. The first time I listened to it.
I didn't hate it. I was just like, oh, okay.
It's a little too...
Because he has such a great voice.
And plus the time signatures were changing a lot. I don't know.
But the time signatures, you learn to appreciate the...
I didn't like the way they did it initially.
Can we listen to that song?
No. It's not on the list today.
How were they live?
Amazing.
Really, really
loved
good.
It. Perfect, actually.
Yeah, really good. We listened to the Stand Ups to Me, and I think that's all that we're playing is Andrew Ballou.
Oh, Amazing guitarist. If you guys have not heard of Adrian, it's Adrian. You said Andrew.
I'm sorry, Adrian.
Sorry. If you haven't heard of Adrian Ballou, makes sounds out of a guitar that should not be humanly possible.
His show, like the show he puts on, is awesome.
Amazing.
And he's very, very tall.
Yeah.
I would know there's nothing about that.
There's a picture of us with him. So
yeah. Are you gonna flash it up?
Yep.
Yes. And then Serentip. I really enjoy her album. I think you need to give it a listen.
She's like Imogen Heap, except a local version.
Sure, I guess. I don't know what Imogen Heap is.
She's an amazing... Same premise, less dancey, more interesting.
Okay.
I enjoyed the song. I really like his voice. I thought the deep voice was a little abrupt, and I wish it lasted a little longer if he was going to do that. But
Maybe if it was the chorus.
Yeah.
Or just all verse.
Just some part of it. Yeah. Just a little longer to extend it.
Yeah.
I enjoyed it, though, overall. It's not like a favorite of mine in this genre, because I have listened to a lot of different soul and funk and stuff like that.
Mm-hmm.
This I would give like a
3.3.
Definitely enjoyable. Loved a lot of things about it. Just nothing stand out about it to make me say, I want to go back and listen to this guy. This song.
I would listen to him, but I would only... See, here's my thing lately. I'm only going to listen to some of these bands, like if I like a one or two songs, if they're on a record.
Right.
There's just
because there's a certain sound quality that makes sense to go with it.
And for me to go get up and put it on, it takes some effort. So I'm just like, I like to listen to it, and I put it on with a purpose.
Yes. Well, yeah. Yeah, I understand.
I give it a 4. Like a low 4.
You give it a 4?
Like a 4. Just a 4.
Yeah, it's a 3.3 for me.
Yeah.
Somewhere in there.
It's a generous 4.
Yeah, it's a generous 3.3.
Because I'm sure there's a lot of, like, other, like, funk guys I'm going to listen to first.
Precisely. Thank you for sticking with us on our little break and figuring things out with us. Because we're figuring things out, but we're...
I was really surprised about the reception on that. Actually, I wasn't surprised. I knew people would be like, all right, you're fine, dude.
Yeah.
You were a little bit more worried.
No, I wasn't.
Check out Justin's channel. It's actually really, really good. I'm really just looking at the audio quality.
That's all you look at.
It's really good. I like it. Like, you've done your thing, and I like how you bring Natasha in every once in a while. I gotta jump on.
It was funny. No.
I want to jump on.
It doesn't make sense to.
It's
I thought
funny.
About it.
It's funny.
It's JPMP.
You know, I'm just gonna show
it's up. It's not just JPMP. You might as well just do JPMP.
I'm gonna come in.
Come in?
I'm gonna come in.
What, are you a rapper now? Thank you guys so much for watching. Really appreciate it. Join us in the comments down below for discussion. Let us know what you guys thought of the song. Join us on Twitter as well. Join me on my solo channel, Just JP, link in the description.
I don't know if you should be...
I'm literally doing the outro and you're messing with my groove.
I don't know if you should be plugging it every episode, your channel, because it's kind of like... It's kind of... That's like me plugging in my business.
Then you can do the intro and the outro then. You want that position?
I don't mind doing the outro. Sure. It's not like I have to do it every week. Anyway, guys, thank you so much for watching. I almost said Just JP.
See? It's hard.
JPMP. Well, this is my first day. It's my first day. Anyway, thank you guys so much for watching us. We seriously appreciate it. Join us in the comments down below. Do not join us on Instagram because we're not there. Join us on Twitter instead. We post random things, funny things, selfful things.
Post something right now.
And also...
sorry, I'm on Just JP, which you guys should be as well. Look at that, I'm making it up for since I can't mention it every
and then
time.
And then also, what else are we doing? What else do you say at the end of it?
I don't know, dude.
Oh, hang on, I'm gonna say it. You know they're going to watch this, right? They're going to watch all this. Don't cut this, please.
I'm not. Tell me when you...
I'm going to do it right now.
What?
I'm going to do the outro.
I'm taking a picture.
Oh, you're going to take the picture? Okay.
Do the outro!
I did! Thank you guys for watching. Join us in the comments down below. Join us on Twitter. Do not join us on Instagram. And we will see you guys. We will see you guys in the next one.
Bye.